United States and including the National League to the and that is the same thing about details of the thing for me, most important thing is the branding is one that should start in from the grassroots. Really, as it states, agreement is the right to take the grassroots and we are talking to the people. And I think people have found a sense of belonging.
Those CD groups, we don't have a
go to any of these ministries that relate to what you are doing, an engineer, for example, the sanitation group. They are looking for people to come and do a campaign to ensure that we keep up being in our kitchens. Yes. We have, for example, the NYSC Tape. I don't think we have a problem relating to the Ministry of Health. So I think in that, talking about that particular group that is the one that collectively, I think there is not a major problem. I think the main challenge is the individual CDPs. I think the challenge is not on the ministry. The challenge is on the individual, because that is what makes you stand out. Your potential, your capacity to alone conceive an idea, to go out of your way, to source and make sure that this is achieved, your ability to convince people, to get people's buy-in on your project, and then be able to implement it. That is what makes you stand out. That is why you are given the award for having the best CV. If what you were supposed to have a program to say each person that has his own personal CV goes to submit and you support you and do what is unique about it. There's nothing unique about it. Then why do we select people that stand out for awards? The idea is the selflessness, the commitment. This is why you are giving your all to the service of the nation. So whatever it takes, how you do your things, nobody asks. When you ask these people that collect awards, how are you able to achieve this? No, it is only rated. You feel called to respect, see what you have done, and then you are commended, and it is your magic. So it is the magic that is within each core member to really excel and stand out. So I think that is how I understand.
Yes, yes, yes. People are used to keeping this going back to the next. So what are your views on the concept of the brand in Nigeria?
I think the concept is, as I said, unique. It's unique in the sense that proud people, good nation, good people. How else would you want yourself as a Nigerian to be looked at when you go out of this nation? If you can send this message, if it can stick in everyone's head globally, wherever you go, when they say Nigeria, everybody can just think of good nation, good people. That is a positive thing. And I think it is a step in the right direction. If we can, ensure that it works the way it is, and when you say Nigeria, part of Africa, I think that was the first one. Before the second report. That has also given Nigeria that position. Nigeria is the most populous black nation. Because it is the heart of Africa, that means without it, the continent of Africa will not come, the heart will not come. So I think all the concepts that they developed until today have been hit spot on. And I think more should be done in the
future.
Yes, sir. That's what I mean.
So how can we, the youth, contribute to the branding of Nigeria?
Well, we should start by building ourselves wherever we go. We should include ourselves wherever we go. If we say good nation, good people, and you are out of this country, wherever you find yourself, even within the country, you are relating with people. You should be able to portray that image. And one that comes from a good nation is a good person for yourself. So, this is important. We need to stand out, we need to be unique, whatever we do. And I believe that in doing so, then we will surely be a great nation. Well, I would not say yet. I mean, I would say that the NYSC parent camp legislate has come to reality. Why? Because a contract has been awarded. The design, I think I could make the design available to you. You take pictures of it or whatever you have to do with it. And the contractors are preparing to mobilize the site. They were not on site because there were issues of compensations that were not fully paid. as you know, the part of land that was donated by the local Americans, which was donated free of encumbrances. But then there was additional land to ensure expansion because of the vision of the chief servant. It's always good to look ahead 20, 30 years from now. And a larger parcel of land was needed. And before this land could be accessed by surveyors or the contractor, etc., all the compensations needed to be paid. And this we concluded 2 weeks ago. All farmers, economic trees, etc., have been fully paid, and the contractor now is prepared to bring this to site. This is a contract worth 150. It's in four phases. The total amount that will be spent in the permanent site for the entire phase 1 to 4 is about ₦500 million. But for the first phase, which will see to the construction of the hostels that will house 2,000 core members with additional spaces for possible additional facilities. But for now, we believe it will complement what is already on and we'll be able to at least accommodate 4,000 to 5,000 core members, which I think is more than enough between now and the next 5 years. It has also got sporting facilities, recreational facilities, cafeterias, hospital clinics, decent water guard, and most importantly, within the phase one, the entire land that has been acquired will be fenced so that we know that this area is secure and just awaiting development. So I think this has become a reality, and I know you will not enjoy it. We'll probably come back to say that this was started when we were here.